Well, hi, everybody. It's David George Brook, that gratitude guy, with another special guest on the Gratitude Interview Pandemic. We're talking to people, a gratitude podcast interview, I should say. And I was thinking about my next guest, which I'll introduce in a second. Kyle Willis, I've known a number of years, and I was thinking it always concerns me, and I know people that are a lot younger than me, they're that much smarter than I am. It just always makes me just a little intimidated, but nonetheless, a great guy, and he's just become a good friend and somebody who I really count on for a lot of things too. So, Mr. Kyle Willis. Kyle, welcome to the podcast.
Hey, thank you so much, David. Glad to be here.
You bet. So what I'm doing is, when I'm doing these interview podcasts or podcast interviews, is just to really kind of see if we can help some people out there that might be struggling, that might aren't as well equipped maybe to handle. So my first question for you is, what is your best coping mechanism to deal with this pandemic?
I think that the first thing that I keep reminding myself is that this isn't the end. The reality that there is light at the end of the tunnel, as dismal as it is, as hard as it is, as painful as it is for a lot of people right now, we're not going to end here. This isn't the end of our story. This isn't the end of our lives. This isn't the end for everyone. I know not everyone can say that, but for myself right now, the reality that what feels negative, what feels painful, what feels rough right now, I'm going to get through this, and I'm going to become stronger at the end of it.
Yeah. And you know, one of my, if not my biggest subject, only subject is gratitude. Have you noticed since we've gone into this, we were just saying it's about 4 or 5 weeks into it, what you're grateful for, has it changed from then to now? Is it the same thing? Is it something different maybe as we've gotten into this and what you're grateful for?
I think two things that I would highlight. I'll start simple to begin with, and then I'll get a little deep in a moment. The first thing I think when it comes to simplicity is the aspect of time. We have a lot of time right now to just be present, to be available, to be real, and be around. And, you know, my wife, she owns 2 hair salons. And so she's forced to stay at home right now. And it's been tougher. Like, she's telling me yesterday, she had to cancel almost 400 appointments one salon. Wow. Because of the stay-at-home order, and no real clue yet of when she's going to get through it. But that aspect of time has allowed her to just be present, be home with our 2 kids. My 2-year-old, almost 2-year-old, celebrates her 2nd birthday here on Saturday. And it's allowed me to look at what I do with my, you know, I run a digital marketing agency. And so we've had the fortunate privilege that a lot of the work we're doing is online, so it doesn't require a physical store presence. Certainly some of our clients have been affected, but it's allowed me to look at my schedule and say, what can I put off right now? Where can I just be present and be real and available to the family? As I don't get this much FaceTime with my wife normally, she's at the salon most every day of the week. And using that time to go on family walks, to do some spring cleaning, reorganize the garage and crawl space, and then just be, you know, I've been taking my little 2-year-old out on little mini adventures, whether it be driving to go to the post office or just walk her around the block and just be present as a family and grateful for that aspect of, I don't normally get this much time with them, but I get to enjoy now.
Right, exactly. Now, I think back on knowing you, and one of the things I would say, you always have a ton of things going on, and there's just all sorts of juggle. I say juggling the balls a lot, because that's my favorite way to describe it. That's one of the reasons why you and I connected. There's always the mind is going 100 miles an hour, it seems. But not everybody is that way. And so when you've got people that are sheltering at home, what's some thoughts or ideas or maybe some concepts or something that somebody could be doing while they're stuck at home during this time?
Yeah. Absolutely. I mean, the big thing for me is I love to find a way to stay connected. You know, as we're doing here on Zoom, the ability that, as you know, you and I see each other about once a week when we're at the office space or life in general, and we get the face-to-face time. And if we can't have that like this, and hey, how do we stay connected in things like Zoom? Last night, we did a Zoom game night with another family where it was kind of a game. I think it's called Quiplash. It's like an apples to apples type of a game. Right. We did a screen share, played this game with another family, and like we would have face to face, they were over at our house for a dessert and game night. we all had our drinks and had our food and spent an hour or so playing together as two families would. And then, you know, trying to just other ways of staying connected in the old school way of just helping people feel valued and loved. We did a bunch of handwritten cards to friends and family from my 2-year-old. Did a little handprint on the card. As a family, all wrote little notes to my parents and other friends around the country, and then just sent off those cards to just say, "Hey, we all know we're sitting around doing nothing right now, or doing what we can right now. Just know you're in our thoughts. We love you. Hope you're making the best of this time right now."
That's cool. And you know, when they first came up with social distancing, they kind of corrected it later to say physical distancing. You know, so sure. We're apart physically, but with, again, as you say, Zoom, and I rely on FaceTime. I FaceTime my younger son in San Diego all the time. And it's just, there's all this technology, which is really one of the big silver linings through this entire pandemic and where the whole world is involved. But some people, again, aren't quite as creative. And that's why I was curious too. And speaking of that, Kyle, in the digital marketing world, but just in your world altogether, this is going to end at some point. We don't know when, but it will end. And there will probably more likely be a new normal to what we're going to do. But being as motivated and as driven as you are, what's some thing or things that you're doing right now to kind of hit the ground running when this thing moves on to the next phase? We're not in our homes.
Absolutely, yeah. You know, the businesses that are flourishing in this time are the ones who laid the groundwork to build ways to stay connected to their audience, to their customers. And I get it, a lot of businesses have the brick and mortar presence. They have a harder time being able to stay connected as well. If I can't, you know, one of our clients is a car dealership. It's a little hard to sell cars right now.
Right.
But one of our clients is a hair salon. As I mentioned, my wife, you know, working with her, like, all right, well, what can you do right now? Well, people can't get haircuts right now. They need to know what can I do to protect my roots or protect my hair as my roots grow out and I can't color my hair. Well, she put together a little root kit, she called it.
Oh, nice.
She could sell for $20, mail off to people to say, hey, here's some root conditioning treatment you can do until we get out of this mess and you can come back into the salon. And you know, those in this time, what a business can do really well is start working on what is the things that they've kind of been putting off for a lot of businesses. It's the content creation of your blog, updating your website. If you don't have a website, now try and take the time to build one. We're building like 8 websites right now for clients because it's that time of, well, I got nothing else to do right now. I haven't really built that digital presence online. Maybe I should get started.
Right.
Sweet. Yeah. You know, who knows if we ever go through a pandemic like this before. Let's make sure you're prepared. And right. So you have a way to stay connected. If you've not built an email list, now's the time to build that email list and get connected. And then the important aspect of that is just be human. Don't have to just sell all the time. Stay connected. How can you serve in the midst of this? And you know, I hate the buzzword of value, but I think that aspect of how can you support your customers as much as they want to support you, there's nothing wrong with being willing to say, hey, here's where I need support. If you buy this item, this helps keep our lights on when we come back. And this is going to help you when you're sitting at home. And so finding a way that there's a mutually beneficial exchange of what you can provide to your customer base and what they can do to help keep you in business as
right. possible. That's a great point. And I think to your earlier point too, I have a feeling that a lot of to-do lists are getting done that have been put off for a long time. So they're way down the priority list, but now here we are stuck. So great input. So Kyle, last question, do you have sort of a mantra, a quote, a saying, a philosophy that is kind of represents how you move through life and certainly through a tough time like this? I mean, I asked somebody and they said, well, this too shall pass. But do you have something that's kind of been at the sort of overarching for you as you've gone through life?
Yeah, you know, whether your audience is religious or not, I think this concept will apply. I've always held on to that that truth. It comes from the Bible, where in the New Testament, the author is talking about love. And he says, you know, love is patient, love is kind. And I always love that aspect about love believes the best. Right. And that's something that I've been holding on to in this time of that, all right, I believe the best. I believe that as, you know, stutter because I don't want to get into too negative a topic, but I had a friend lose their father due to the COVID illness.
Oh, wow.
And as I've been trying to just encourage and support them, it's really helped me think of just what is love right now? How do I love them in the midst of this time? How do I love my family in the midst of this time? Start off by believing the best. As hard, as painful, financially, relationally, emotionally, as this time has been for a lot of businesses and individuals, I'm going to believe the best, that we're going to get through it. We're going to be stronger in the midst of this. And how can we unite? Love is what unites us.
Right. Oh, that's great. That's great. Well, of course, as I expected, quality content, speaking of content creation from Dr. Willis. So thank you so much. I really appreciate you being on the old Gratitude Podcast interview.
I'm honored for the invite. Thank you so much, David.
You bet. Thanks, Kyle.